Hello, welcome back to my sneaker channel. It's been a few weeks, I'm super busy. So I'd like to do a shout out to the two people asked me to do a review because they've been missing me. Thank you both, my two friends on YouTube. And also I've actually hit over 400 subscribers, which for someone that just does a silly little YouTube channel for sneakers as an old dude is quite nice. So cheers everybody. If you want to follow me, give me a subscribe. It will be around here somewhere. And if you want to follow me on Instagram, you can see even more intermittent pictures of sneakers, generally on my feet. And that is here, which is at Jordy Kicks. So, as you've seen by the title, we have an unboxing, and I have the actual box because it's just arrived today, of these very classic Gucci low tops. So I spotted these on, they're on one of these videos, which is like famous people wear low top sneakers or wear sneakers, and I was like, oh, I like them. And I've actually got some Gucci driving shoes, the sort of brown ones with the knobbly bottoms, and they're very nice. And the quality just oozes out of them. They weren't cheap, they were 300 quid, and these are around about £410, but don't tell anybody. But before I get into this quick unboxing, I wanted to do a really quick, just a comparison to other low top sneakers I've got, because obviously low tops aren't quite sneakers. They're sort of half a sneaker, half a shoe, and a little bit different. So I've actually got these ones. So these are sort of my, as you can see, my super beaten classics. These are Whistles low tops. And I got these because they were in a sale. They were hyper cheap. I think I got them for something like 60 quid. Two real issues with them is one is they are, they're sort of minty green, which I think you can see on the picture. Through the dirt there, they're actually sort of this minty white, which is not ideal. And the other thing is they're a tiny bit big, and you tend to find on these low tops that they can run anywhere between true to size, half a size down, or a full size down. And you've really got to try them on. You can never really tell beforehand. These run probably half a size too big. I could probably even squeeze in the size down on these. But these are my normal size of 11. They're a little bit big. But for the price I paid for them, 60 quid or whatever it was, they're amazing quality. They're from Portugal, I believe. And they're fully leather lined on the inside. And the only problem with the Whistles ones, and they do bring them out every year, is they sell out so quick and they never have any other models of them in. So that's sort of a Whistles pair I've got, which are probably about ready for the knacker's yard, to be honest. I've also got this pair here, which are, they're sort of Buddy, what they're called again. So they're Buddy Bull Terrier Lows. So it's a Japanese company, Buddy. They're actually handmade in Japan. There's some really nice videos on YouTube about how the guy who owns this company hand makes all of these himself. Made in Japan, they're Japanese leather from a Japanese cow. And they're nice. For the price, I think I paid about 130 for these, and again these are a bit tatty, and they're nice, but I find the sole a little bit too soft. So it's got a very soft sole, so when you walk around in them all day, it's got quite a soft sole, and the leather lining is only half lined, so you've got a bit of lining to the sides and the back, but not to the front and to the tongue. So you know, you sort of get what you pay for on that one. So that's the Buddy Bull Low Terriers. So that's another pair of lows I've got. And I got those because they were proper white rather than an off-white greeny. And then actually, if you're gonna in the market for sort of mid-priced low tops, these are the ones I'd recommend. And these are the ETQ Amsterdam ones. Now I got these in the black because I wanted some black ones. And you get a really nice box with them, really nicely packed. And that's it there. These are really, really well made. This is a black one. They're super comfy, a really good solid sole. They are fully leather lined, so just double check that. Yeah, these are fully leather lined. So these are, what did I say again, ETQ? Yeah, ETQ Amsterdam. And these, I think they were about 180, maybe 170, something like that. You could probably pick them up in various sales. These are in black. These are a gorgeous low tops. So if you want a mid-price low top, these ETQ Amsterdam's perfect. Just go and get some. Don't bother with any of the others. A great shoe. And these fit true to size. And the Buddies fit true to size as well. The Whistles don't. Half a size, maybe even a full size. So let's chuck all that to the side. And let's get to the actual title, which is these white classic. These are the classic green Gucci low tops. So I'm going to open them on camera, but it's going to be speeding up. Like that. So while it speeds up, just bear with me while I open these puppies up. Ta-da! So there we go. So with this being Gucci, you get all sorts of bits and bobs. And I remember this when I bought my sort of driving shoes. So you get a Gucci bag. Lovely, never gonna use it. Gucci bag, anybody? We have the box itself, which I'll have a look at in a minute. And you get some nice bits and bobs. You get a little letter here, which says, thank you. Cheers, Gucci. And then we get another letter here, which is my sort of return instructions and everything else, but all in a very nice sort of Gucci style envelope. So get what you pay for here. And we've got this gorgeous box. I mean, you know, boxes are boxes, and I've got reams and reams of sneaker boxes downstairs, trainer boxes. But you can see this one's a little bit special. Very nice. So I'll pull off the ribbon. So it has a Gucci ribbon around it. Gone. And there we have, so Gucci lid. Very nice. Take that off. More bits and bobs inside. Gucci responsibility. No idea what that is. And I don't care. So, very nice. There you go. So yes, as always with Gucci, they come in basically silk purses. You've got a little silk bag there with a Gucci label, which is sort of tacked onto it. That's the Gucci bag. So we have the two here. Put them to the side for a minute. Nothing else in the box. Let's fold away this ribbon. Tissue paper. Gone. So here we go. Out of the this silk bag, we have, very, very nice. So here we go. So this is the sneaker. First time I've seen it, actually in the flesh. I've never seen it in the flesh before. So I bought these. I was told many, many times these were running big. So I bought these half a size down. So these are a 10 and a half UK. So hopefully these fit. I'll let you know at the end of the video in the comments, and we'll see it on foot. But hopefully, let's just double check it. Looks about right. So let's try these out. So what do we get with this? So as you can imagine, more tatting there. We get a very, very high quality leather on this. This is a super high quality leather. I think it's a fairly soft leather as well. So if I check that against the ETQ, what I do find about the ETQ is it's a very hard leather, which is great because it means it's very hard wearing. But compared to this, to the Gucci, this is a very soft leather. I don't know if it's a Nappa leather or a calf leather, but very, very nice. And you know, if you're Italian, Nappa and calf might actually mean the same thing. So this is the white one. You can get this in a blue as well. So this is just a very plain, sort of what I call the classic Gucci. You can have it where the back is in blue and the side is in blue. And there's also various other ones as well. You can get it with bees on it and loads of embroidery all over it and big bows on here. But I just wanted the classic, super classic, white and green. And there, as you can see, there it is. And it's a gorgeous, gorgeous sneaker. Very soft leather, very, very soft. A lovely stitch line, as you can see, that goes down here. If we look at the sole, it's got sort of a pebbled effect here and very smooth around the front. That continues around very smooth back to the pebbled effect there to the back. We have the sort of rear crocodile leather. So you have this sort of crocodile leather on the back. You can see the Gucci logo across there. And again, this is a very, very nice leather. And you know, so made in Italy. So these are actually made in Italy. They're not made in China. They're not made in Portugal or anything else. These are handmade in Italy. And we can see inside, we have the Gucci in the sole, and these are fully leather lined all the way through. Just see inside there, fully leather lined. Let's have a look in. Yeah. And then we have the model number that's just sort of pressed onto the inside of the tongue. So let's get the other one out so we can just see them as a pair. Get rid of that. Tuck these laces in. And there we have them as a nice pair. There we go. We have the sort of crocodile leather on the back. The other thing, obviously, which is the very Gucci thing that's going on, is we have the sort of Gucci fabric to the side. So it's obviously the green red green, which is the Gucci logo, and that's on my shoes, my other sort of driving shoes as well. And it's a fabric, and I wasn't quite sure before I got it whether it was going to be flapped or, but no, it's actually stitched on, and it's fully in place. That's not going anywhere. You're not going to be able to get your finger in there or anything. And that's it. This is a gorgeous, gorgeous shoe. So that's about all you can say on it. I mean, handmade in Italy, super, super soft calf leather of some sort. These are beautiful white. It's not an off-white, it's a very nice white. As I said, we've got the pebble and the smooth and the bottom. And we have a nice round toe cap, which I also quite like. And this is very much like, we have a round toe on my ETQs as well. And on the base, what have we got? So on the base, we've got sort of Gucci, made in Italy, and we have the Gucci sort of crest on the base. Gorgeous shoe. Is it worth £410? Don't tell anybody. Yeah, I think so. I really, really like my driving shoes. And they're probably, what, 4 years old now. And I did something stupid when I bought them, so I went and wore them in the desert. So some of the leather's worn away a bit, but these are well worth the money. I mean, they're not cheap, but you know, you can pay resale for a lot of sneakers nowadays, especially when you're looking at the Mars yards and the like. You can pay anything between £5 to £1,000, and even more if you're looking at some of the Virgils. So you know, £410 for a set of low tops, if you look after them, will last you a decade or more, no problems at all. These have lasted me, what, 3-4 years now, just about ready to go in the Knacker's yard. These here will last me for quite some time, because this is a super, super shoe. If you're not apt to paying £410, you can get yourself these. Whoops, I just moved my camera there. Move it back. Yeah, if you're not up to paying the £410 for these, then you can very easily get these for the £180 mark. So, Gucci Classic Low Tops in the beautiful green. Really, really nice sneaker. So what I'll do, and I'll speed it up a bit, so I'm just going to do a speedy up bit again. Let me move my camera back up. Stupid, stupid man. So let me do a very quick on foot. I'll take these up, but I'll speed it all up, and I'll let you know how they fit on camera, because it's some people don't read the comments, do they? So speeding up now. Okay, speed up done. On foot, it's true to size. So I've gone half a size down. So I'm usually an 11 in Adidas. Sometimes I'm a 10 and a half or an 11 in Nike. So for Nike. Or Nike, if you're English and you're going to shout at me for saying Nike. If it's a Nike, I'll be 10 and a half to 11. If it's a standard shoe, so I get these were 10 and a half, these Jordans. And if it's a running shoe, because I need a bit of extra space in them, I normally get those at 11. But these are exactly right. So one more time, these are the Gucci's. Love them, love them, love them. Let's have a look at them on foot.